Hello and welcome. So in this video, we will take a deep dive into configuring Windows Hello for Business using Microsoft Intune passwordless authentication, and that will use dual multi-factor unlock, which means it uses both PIN and facial recognition for extra security on the end user Windows device. This is a hybrid environment where on-premise Active Directory is synced to Entra ID using Entra Connect Sync. Also, we'll run through one of the common problems with Windows Hello and using passwordless and PIN authentication. One of the issues is accessing traditional file shares, etc., and authenticating with domain controllers on-premise. The single biggest issue during initial deployment is where a synced user identity is required to authenticate to a hybrid environment. And we have our internet end user Windows 11 device. It's enrolled as an Entra ID joined device. It's a cloud only device. It's not domain joined and it's managed by Intune. But you want the user to still access resources within your domain over a VPN or when the user is in the office over a LAN. This is where Cloud Kerberos Trust comes into action when we create an Azure AD Kerberos server object in the Active Directory domain. This will enable us to authenticate using Microsoft Entra Kerberos to request Kerberos tickets and access on-premise file shares. And this eliminates the need for any complex PKI public key infrastructure using certificates to deliver a simple solution to access. There are some prerequisites for Cloud Kerberos Trust to work correctly. So we need domain controllers with server 2016 or 2019 with the latest updates, MFA in place. We want to run some Entra ID Kerberos PowerShell module, which we'll install and run later on in this video. We want Entra Connect Sync configured, and in our demo environment, we have user sync, password hash sync, and password write back enabled. A client PC, Windows 10 or 11, with the latest updates and a TPM 2.0 chip. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to be notified for more M365 Azure and Intune management guides. So let's get started. So when we take a look at Intune, we have some basic settings under Devices, Enrollment, and Windows Hello for Business. Now these are basic, and they are applied to everyone by default. So we don't want to enable Windows Hello here for this to work correctly. So we need more advanced options for Cloud Kerberos Trust. And the way we get these is to create a profile. And this is explained in the next steps. But first, let's create a user group or device group for Windows Hello. So we will create a group first, and this is recommended to apply our policy in the next section to enable testing to a subset of users for proof of concept. And when happy, all is working, we can then roll out and add more users or devices. Now here I'm creating a user group which will contain users for testing Windows Hello for Business for the purpose of this video. You should also consider a device group instead containing your devices, which will apply settings on a device regardless of who's signed in, and then assign your profiles to a devices group, as settings will be applied consistently to the device before login instead of the user group, which settings may be delayed after login. You can create dynamic device groups containing rule membership, like device name starts with X, and then every device will also be automatically added based upon that rule. So for the purpose of this video, we will create a user group and add a test user. So next we will look at creating the advanced Intune settings for Windows Hello using profiles. Okay, good. So in Intune, we go to devices, configuration, and then we create a new policy. We choose the platform as Windows 10 or later, and the profile type is settings catalog. And then we give the profile a name, and we add a setting, and we choose Windows Hello for Business. We will add what we need here for facial features and PIN security, but please note that the user settings will apply to users and we will apply them to our users group, and they are also the same settings that apply to devices as well, which should be applied to a device group if you are using that. We will also add dynamic lock, which is a feature that automatically locks a Windows device when a Bluetooth paired phone signal falls below the maximum received signal strength. So once we've added in our required settings, let's enable facial anti-spoofing, PIN recovery, and we don't want lowercase letters in the PIN. We want it to be a minimal length of 6, so users don't forget. You can set PIN history. We will require a secure device. This requires the TPM chip module, and we don't want special characters, uppercase letters, and we of course do want to enable Windows Hello for Business, so we set this to true. We apply this policy to our user group containing our test user, and then we click Next and Finish. And next we will show multi-factor unlock, and this is using both a PIN and facial recognition to allow access to the Windows 11 device for extra security. So here we show how to configure multi-factor unlock using a both PIN and facial recognition to allow access to the Windows 11 device for extra security on the end user device. So in Intune, we go to Devices, Configuration, and then we create a new policy. We choose our platform as Windows 10 and later, and the profiles type as Settings Catalog. And then we give it a name, we add a setting, and then under Windows Hello for Business, we will select Group A and Group B. Now we select the GUID for PIN first authentication, and then the second authentication GUID is for facial recognition. We will include the links for these in the description. And then when we're done, we select either the user or device group to apply this to. And then we click Next, and then we click Create. And then we will test this out a bit later and give you a demo in the next sections. Now we want to enable MFA to validate your identity as part of your device registration process. So when onboarding a device out of the box, this prevents successful road device onboarding. And we do this as shown as part of conditional access. So we create a new policy, we give it a name, we select the user group, and then we select the device registration part, and then we apply MFA here. We will cover device lock next to lock a device after a period of time, and then we will test out and demo the settings for device registration MFA applied here during the multi-factor unlock PIN and facial demo. So next up, device lock. So we create a secure policy for this to lock a device after a period of time. So in Intune, Devices, Configuration, Create a New Policy, Platform Windows 10 and Later, Profile Settings Type Catalog, and we search for Inactivity, and we choose Device Lock, and then tick Max Inactivity Time Device Lock. Now this is the maximum amount of time in minutes allowed after the device is idle, and in our case we want to pin lock this device after 5 minutes. And then we apply to our test user group. So here we show multi-factor unlock using both a PIN and facial recognition to allow access to the Windows 11 device for extra security. So we onboard a new device here. We type the username and password of our user in the test group. This applies MFA as we enabled it earlier via conditional access, validate identity as part of the device registration process to prevent successful road device onboarding. You can either configure facial recognition here or configure after PIN entry when it asks to set up additional sign-in security under accounts and sign-in options for facial recognition. Now, when we log in, we carry out multi-factor unlock with our PIN first, and then we have facial recognition second that we specified in our Intune policy with the group GUIDs. We can see on the device reporting in Intune that group A and B have successfully succeeded together with all the other policy settings. Okay, so as explained earlier on in the video, one of the problems with Windows Hello using passwordless and PIN authentication is accessing traditional file shares and authenticating with domain controllers on-premise. With our Windows 11 device enrolled as Entra ID joined, cloud-only device, it's not domain joined, let's try and browse a share on a domain controller. This is using a test user Active Directory domain account that we synced to Entra ID using Entra Connect Sync, and we enrolled our device earlier using this account to Entra ID. When we attempt to browse the share on the domain controller, we are logged in as the test user, but running the klist command shows no Kerberos tickets. It asks for a PIN, and then we get an error and unable to authenticate using Microsoft Entra Kerberos, as we haven't configured and set up Cloud Kerberos Trust yet to request Kerberos ticket granting. So let's set up Cloud Kerberos Trust in the next section to make this work. Okay, so to configure Cloud Kerberos Trust, we first need to run the PowerShell to create an Azure AD Kerberos server object in the Active Directory domain. Okay, good. So now let's paste the PowerShell we copied earlier and amend the UPN of the hybrid identity administrator with our user to log into Azure and amend this with our required username. Let's paste our PowerShell in, and then it prompts us for domain admin credentials for our domain. Let's type those in. After this point, it then prompts us for our Azure credentials, so then we log into Azure. Then once finished, when we refresh Active Directory, we can then see the Azure AD Kerberos server object in the Active Directory domain has been created successfully. You can also view and verify this by running some extra PowerShell from the website here. Next, we will set up the Cloud Kerberos Trust using Intune policies. We will create these with predefined settings. Previously, this was done with a custom OMA-URI settings, but now you can do this with predefined settings in Intune. Okay, so now let's create an Intune policy with predefined settings to configure Cloud Kerberos Trust. So in Intune, go to Devices, Configuration, create the new policy, choose Windows Platform, Windows 10, and later, profile type is Settings Catalog. We give it a name, we add a setting, and then we choose Windows Hello for Business. And then we add in Windows Hello for Business User. This used to be Use Passport for Work. And then Require Security Device User for TPM, and then Use Cloud Trust for On-Prem Auth for AD Kerberos to authenticate on-premise via a ticket. Just to note, there are the equivalent device settings if you are applying to a device group. So we will turn on and enable all these and set to true, and then we will apply to our user group. And let's test this out in the next section. So we're now on our Windows 11 device, and we will run klist, and this lists our Kerberos tickets. We will also run klist space cloud underscore debug lists, and the cloud primary hybrid login TGT is available as one. We can check this device and see it is Azure AD joined only. It's not domain joined or hybrid joined. Now let's try again and browse to our on-premise DC shares now that Cloud Kerberos Trust is configured. And great stuff, we are now successfully authenticated without an error as before. Thanks for watching the video. Hoped it helped. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified for more M365 Azure Intune Management Guides. So catch you all soon and bye for now.